Welcome to the next lesson in your Analytics Mastery course. In this lesson, we are going to have a look at the various web analytics terms, and we are also going to look at the in-depth definitions for each of these terms. So what I am going to do in this particular tutorial is that I am going to show you examples. So by the end of this video, you will be able to understand what each of these terms mean and what is the difference between these terms. So let's get started. So I just logged in into my Google Analytics account, and as soon as you log in, you can see here that some of the terms are right in front of you. So we see terms such as users, sessions, bounce rate, session duration, and once you scroll down a little bit, you can see channels, source or medium, referrals. So there is a section called audience. If I go into audience, you will be able to see terms like users, new users, sessions, number of sessions per user, page views, pages per session, average session duration, bounce rate, etc. So what we will do now is that first we will list out all the important terms and definitions that we use in web analytics, and then we will go ahead and look at each one of them in depth. So what I have done is that I have done my own bit of research, and I have come up with 14 different terms. These are the most important terms that is frequently used in analytics. If you go ahead and look for metrics and terms in analytics, sometimes people have a very long list of 50 to 100 terms, but you need not go to that level of depth. Right now, as we are learning analytics, these are the most important terms. So let's go ahead and have an in-depth look at each of these terms. The first one is annotations. Annotations are notes that help us understand traffic patterns. So you can go ahead and enter annotations inside your analytics account. In one of the videos, I will also show you how to do it. So here you can see that there is an annotation called test. If there is a traffic spike in just one of these days inside your analytics account, and if this spike in traffic is because of an offline campaign that you did, you might not be able to understand why this traffic spike occurred if you are looking at your analytics account maybe 6 months or 1 year down the line. So annotations help us go ahead and record why this traffic spike occurred or a traffic dip occurred. The next one is attribution. Attribution is mostly used to understand the source of sales and revenue inside a funnel. Attribution is mainly classified into first click and last click attribution. We will be having a separate chapter about attribution. So if you consider 100 visitors are being sent to your website from Facebook, 50 visitors from Twitter, and 500 visitors from Google, and end of the day you are having, let's say, 20 sales, you need to find out the sales happened from which source. Maybe all the 15 sales happened from Facebook and another 5 sales happened from Google search. So this helps you understand that no sales happened from Twitter. So this is first click attribution. You need to understand where the click originated from, whether from Facebook, Twitter or Google. So what if Google is providing very less ROI and Facebook is providing good ROI, you will be able to make a decision that you have to invest more efforts into paid advertising and organic activity inside Facebook, because out of the 20 sales, 15 sales came from Facebook and no sales have come from Twitter. So if you are investing a lot of money and energy on Twitter, you might not want to do that because you are not able to attribute any sales back to Twitter. So that's how attribution works, and attribution is important. So in this case, I have explained what is the first click attribution. Last click attribution is basically what is the last page that your user was on, or what is the last click that they did just before the sale happened. So that's how attribution works. In the future videos, when we have a separate chapter about attribution, you will be able to actually build attribution models and execute attribution tracking systems on your own. So let's go to the next term. Bounce rate. Bounce rate is basically the percentage of people who land on one of your web pages and then leave without clicking anywhere else on your website. In other words, single page visitors. So they visit your website and they just leave your website. So these are called bounced visitors. As a general rule, you should try to keep your bounce rate as low as possible, which means that you are getting relevant traffic and you are able to capture people's attention and keep them on your web page. So in general, a normal healthy bounce rate is 70%. If 30% of the visitors are visiting more pages inside your site and clicking around your site, that is good. Sometimes in my case, in my blog, I'm having a bounce rate of 78%, which is a little bit higher. If your bounce rate is 85% or 90%, then you should really be concerned, because that is not a healthy bounce rate. Conversion rate. the number of people who converted on your website divided by the number of people who visited your website. So this conversion can be filling out a form such as lead generation form, or it could be a sale, or it could be any activity as defined by you. It can also be a click. Conversion rate is usually measured for sales and leads. So here, let's say I'm getting 100 visitors to a web page, and out of those 100 visitors, 20 people have filled out a form and they have become leads. So this means that the conversion ratio is 20%. The next one is dimension. Dimension is a characteristic of your data that you can use in filters. So here you can see an example where there are primary and secondary dimensions. Primary dimensions can be keyword, source, landing page, and other. So these are the general dimensions that you have inside Google Analytics. Once you start using Google Analytics, you will get comfortable with what dimension means. The next one is page view. Page view is basically when a page is loaded and Google Analytics tracks the load of the page. It counts even if the same visitor comes back again or refreshes the page. A single user can have even 10 page views in a single session. There is no limit to the amount of page views that this user can have. If a user visits your homepage and refreshes the homepage 10 times, then it is counted as 10 page views. Then there is a term called unique page views, which negates the same user visiting the same page again. Let's say a visitor visits your homepage and then he visits two other pages and then he comes back to the homepage. The total number of page views will be counted as 4 and the unique page views will be counted as 3 because it is the same user. Next one is session. Session is basically defined by a visit by a unique user in a window of 30 minutes. If a visitor comes to your website and spends 1 hour on your website, then it is counted as 2 sessions. So if a user visits my blog in the morning once and in the evening once, then it is also counted as 2 sessions. The next one is users. Users are basically the number of unique users visiting your website. The same user visiting your website on a different day using the same device will be counted as a single user. So to understand users, sessions, and page views, because these are terms which are usually confused with one another, let's go ahead and look at an example. So let's say user A visits your website today. He goes through 5 different pages within 30 minutes. Then it is counted as one user, one session with 5 page views. Let's say the user A visits your website today twice, once in the morning and once in the evening. Then he goes through 5 different pages within 30 minutes in the morning and 3 different pages during his evening session. Now it is one user, 2 sessions and 8 page views. So this is how Google Analytics takes the data and reports it inside your dashboard. Many people go ahead and confuse between page views, unique page views, users and sessions. It is very important that you have a clear understanding of the difference between all these terms so that you will be able to present it to your employer or your agency client with confidence. The next one is called pages per session. This is the number of pages visited on an average session in a given time frame. So this is an average. So here you can see in this report, we have different pages per session for different sources of traffic. So people who are coming from organic search have a higher pages per session. People who are coming directly have lower pages per session. Pages per session is also called page views per session. Both are the same. The next one is entrances. Entrances is the number of times visitors entered your site through a specific page or a set of pages. If I have a page which is inside my blog, not the home page, but a specific article, and if people are coming to my website directly through this page, then it is counted as an entrance. So here I have taken one particular URL and I have taken out the metrics for that particular URL inside my blog. So here you can see the page views, unique page views, average time on page, entrances, bounce rate, and percentage exit for this particular page. And this is usually for a time frame that we define. So when you log in into Analytics, you will be able to define what is the time frame in the calendar. So usually it is the past 1 week that it shows. So here you can see in the past 1 week, there has been 651 new users directly coming to this web page. So this particular web page is ranking well on the search engine. So people are coming to my site for the first time and they're entering through this page. And 84% of those people are also exiting from this page. So which means that they are not visiting further pages on my site. We just had a look at entrances. Percentage exit is the number of exits divided by number of page views for a particular page. It indicates how often users exit from that page or a set of pages when they view the page. So here it is the same URL again. So here you can see percentage exit is 84.33%. So this helps you understand whether they are only interested in the content on that page or whether they are going to other pages and consuming more content. The next one is source. Source is the specific URL from which the traffic has originated from. It could be google.com, facebook.com or digitaldeepak.com. So here you can see what are the top sources for a particular time frame for my blog. And here in the sources section, you can see the different URLs that are listed here. So you can also specify custom sources when you are creating UTM tags, which we will discuss in further videos. So depending upon what source you have given, it will go ahead and show you what is the source of the traffic. But source of the traffic can be very lengthy and it can contain a lot of sites. So there is something called Medium, and what Medium does is that Medium shows you what is the type of source that you are getting traffic from. So here some examples include organic, CPC, referral, email and things like that. So Medium can be a lot of things even if it means the same thing. For example, sometimes for social media people use SM, sometimes they use social space media, sometimes they use the word social media. So if someone else is sending traffic to your web page and if they are using these mediums in the UTM tags or the URL tags, then it is ranked as different things inside the Medium report. So to solve this problem, there is something called channels. So channels are basically default groups of traffic sources with multiple similar mediums, and channels are very standard and it is developed by Google Analytics themselves. So here you can see the different channels on the right: organic, search, direct, email, social, referral, other. So these are the six different channels, standard channels inside Google Analytics. So Medium could be social, social network, social hyphen media, SM, social network or social space media. For all these mediums, Google is going to take the channel as social and it is going to show you in the channel report. So I prefer that you don't use mediums much. Mediums is just to specify where the traffic is coming from. When you are looking at reports, you have to look at sources and then you have to look at channels. Channels give you a very clear idea and a broad idea of where your traffic is coming from. There is also this answer on Google support. I have given the URL in this slide. I will also link the URL below this video. Go ahead and have a look at that support answer from Google, which clearly explains what mediums are categorized into specific channels. So let's go ahead and recap all the 14 different terms that we just had a look at. So first one is annotations, where you go ahead and take notes inside your analytics account. Then you have attribution. You find out where is the source of traffic and which source of traffic actually gave you revenue. You have bounce rate, so the percentage of people leaving your site without clicking on anything else is called bounce rate. We have conversion rate. Conversion rate is a percentage of people who are taking a specific action predefined by you. You have dimension. Dimension can be different types of views on how you are looking at analytics. It could be landing pages, it could be keywords and things like that. You have page view, so every time a page loads, a page view is counted. You have session. So session is a visit by a user in a 30-minute period. Users are unique users who are visiting from specific devices. So they are categorized as users. Pages per session. So the amount of page views in a particular session on average is pages per session. You have entrances, the number of people coming to a specific web page in a given frame of time. Then you have percentage exit, which is the percentage of people exiting from a specific web page after they have entered that web page. You have source. Source can be specific URLs. It can be google.com, reddit.com, facebook.com or digitaldeepak.com. You can go ahead and define sources when you are driving traffic using URL parameters. Then you have medium. There are multiple different mediums such as CPC, organic, email, and sometimes there could be different medium terms such as social media, SM, etc., but they all mean the same and they are categorized into channels. There are six different channels as defined by Google. This includes organic search, direct, email, referral, social and other. So that's it for this video. I will also leave a link to the PDF format of this slide deck below this video and I will also send it to you on email. Make sure that you go ahead and have a look at all these terms and definitions once in a while so that you don't forget them. Because if you are not going to refresh your memory of these terms frequently, you might forget them. And it is very important as a digital marketer when you are using analytics that you understand what each of these terms mean. So thank you for watching this video, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.